Hello and welcome to this beginner's tutorial on IntelliJ IDEA. In this session, we are going to learn in a very basic way, step by step, how to download and set up IntelliJ, and you can follow this on Windows and Mac operating system. All through this series on IntelliJ, I will show you very basic step by step how to use IntelliJ, and do not worry if this is the first time you are using IntelliJ. I will show you all the steps and we will start from scratch. So let's get started. I am Raghav and you can find all my work on my website automationstepbystep.com. And with this, let us start with our step number one on how to download and set up IntelliJ. The first step is we have to download the community edition of IntelliJ. And if you are on Windows, you can go to your browser and just search for IntelliJ download, and this will take you to this website, download IntelliJ IDEA. This is from jetbrains.com, and here you can see we have IntelliJ available on Windows, Mac and Linux platforms, and we have two editions, the ultimate version and the community edition. The ultimate version is the enterprise version and community is free and available as open source, and you can also see the comparison of the ultimate and the community edition here. So we are going to work on the community edition, and you can see here you can download the exe file that you can use to install IntelliJ on Windows, or you can also get the zip folder and you can just unzip and then use IntelliJ. So I'm downloading the zip folder. If you wish, you can just get the exe and install IntelliJ, and it is downloading the zip folder here. In a moment, I will also show you this on Mac, but just let me complete the Windows part here. So this is downloaded. Let me go to my downloads folder, and you can see this is downloaded here. I can extract it. You can extract and keep this folder on any location on your system, wherever you have permission to use the folder. As of now, I'm extracting it on the downloads folder itself. And once this is downloaded, you can just open the folder, go to the bin folder, and you will find a file, a application file for IntelliJ that we can use to start IntelliJ. So this is step number one. This is the link from jetbrains.com from where you can download IntelliJ. And if you are on Mac, let me very quickly show you on Mac as well. If you are on Mac, you can again go to Google and just search for IntelliJ IDEA download, and this will again take you to the same website, and you can go here, and this time we will go to the Mac, and you can download the DMG file that we can use to start the IntelliJ application on Mac. So this will start downloading the DMG file. So meanwhile, this is downloaded. Let us go back to our Windows system, and here it is unzipping the folder. So let this complete, and yes, this is done. So this is the folder. Let me show you from the downloads folder. So you can see this folder is here unzipped, and I will go inside the folder. You will find a bin folder here, and here you will find our application for IntelliJ. So you can see here, if I scroll down, you can see this is the IDEA 64 application. That will open IntelliJ on my Windows system. So this is opening IntelliJ IDEA, the latest version on the Windows system. So you can see this is done. Let me just close the project. This was a project I was creating earlier. So of course, if this is a fresh installation for you, you will not see any project. Let me just close everything. And yes, this is how you should see the IntelliJ window. We have projects, customized plugins, learn IntelliJ IDEA, all these options. So this is on Windows. If you're on Mac, so this is downloaded. You can go to your folder, and you can see this is the DMG file. You can just double click the DMG file and then put the file into the applications folder, and then it will start IntelliJ on Mac system as well. So you can just have to, you just have to drag and drop this into the applications folder, and that's it. I will say replace because there was already a file there, and that's it. If I now want to start, if I say IntelliJ, see I'm pressing command and spacebar on my keyboard, which brings up this search, spotlight search, and as I start typing IntelliJ, I'm getting this IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition app, and this will open IntelliJ. So this was already open on my Mac, so let me just close this. And we have done step number one, and step number two is we have to check if JDK is installed on our system. So you can go to your command line. I am pressing cmd and go to command prompt, and I will say java space hyphen version. And if you get this message which shows you the java version and all the details, that means java jdk is set up and installed on your system. You can also say java c space hyphen version to check the version of java compiler. In my case it is already added, and I will show you in case it is not added for you. And do not worry about the jdk version. In IntelliJ, if you want, you can use a different jdk for different projects on the IntelliJ IDEA IDE. So here, just in case Java is not set up on your system, you can go on my website, that is automationstepbystep.com, and here if you scroll down, you will find a section for programming, and here you will find a link for Java. This will take you to my YouTube playlist on Java, and you can see here this tutorial, how to install Java on Windows and how to install or update Java on Mac. So just in case Java JDK is not installed on your system, you can watch this and get Java JDK installed on the system. And if you are on Mac, again you can go to terminal. I am pressing command spacebar to bring up spotlight search, and I will type terminal, and here again I will say java space hyphen version, and I have java 8 here. I can say java c space hyphen version to check the java compiler version, and again this is also there. So this is done on my Mac, it is there, and Windows as well it is there. So I can exit from here. So this was step number two, and we have already installed and opened IntelliJ IDEA. So we have already done step number three, and now we can create a new project. So to create a new project, you can just go to this window, projects. This is the start window when you start IntelliJ for the first time, or in case any project is open, if you close the project, you will see this window, and here you can see all the options. So we have project, and here we have option to create a new project. If you want, you can also open an existing project, or you can get a project from version control system. All this we will see later. For now, I will click on new project here, and here you will see all these options. You can create a Java project, you can create a Maven, Gradle, Android, you can also create IntelliJ plugin. We have Java, FX, Groovy, Kotlin, or empty project. Let me go and select Java, and here you can select the project SDK. So by default on my system I have Java 8, but if you scroll down, or if you click on this drop down, you can see you can add a different JDK. In case it is already present on your system, you can scroll and you can browse the folder of your JDK and change the JDK, or if you want to add a new JDK, download and add, you can say download JDK. And here you can select the version of JDK that you want, and you can see the vendor here, select the vendor here, and then when you say download, it will download and add that JDK in your project. We will also see some more option how to configure a JDK in a project, but as of now let me go by the default. And here you have some additional library and framework. If you want to add it to the project, you can check this. Groovy and Kotlin you can add to a Java project, but as of now I will keep it as it is and click on next. And here if you want to create a project from a template, you can use this template. You can see here this is a simple Java application that includes a class with main method, so it is good. I will get a class with main method already created, so I'm checking this and click on next. And here I can give a name to my project, let us say hello world. And here you can select the project location wherever you want to store your project. You can select from here, so you can browse and select if you want to change the location. And then here you can give the package name, so I will say the package name as com.hello, and that's it. Click on finish, and it says this directory does not exist. I will say create, and that's it. So you can see it has created a project, Hello World. It has also created a main.java file. So if you go here and expand, and in case you do not see this project window, you can just click here. So you can see here, here it is project. You can click here, so you can get the project structure here. And also if you press Control E on your keyboard, if I press Control E on my keyboard, I get this option of recent sections or files. Again, I have project here, so I can get a project here as well. And let me just put it here on this side, and that's it. Yeah, now this is fine. And now you can see we have this project. Inside we have a src folder, and then inside the src folder we have com.hello package and the main.java class, which is already created. If you want, you can create more classes here. So you can do a right click, new, and create a Java class. And then you can find all the external libraries added in this project here. And I will show you some more configuration of the project. But as of now, if you want to run this project, you can see here we have the main method. I can write something here. I can say sout and click enter. So it has auto completed system.out.println statement. And here I can say hello world, and that's it. I will save, I will press Control S, and now you can see we have this option, we have this run button here. And using this run button, I can run this main method. I can also do a right click and say run main, or I can just click on this run button here and say run main, and this will run the project. So it will configure the project. In case it needs to download anything, it will download, and then it will run it. And you can see here we are getting the output hello world. So that was very simple. This is how you can set up, download and install and set up IntelliJ and create a project. And in the coming sessions we will see some more options, what are the other features and some other configurations. I hope this was very useful for you. If you have any questions, you can let me know in the comment section below, and I will see you in the next session. Thank you for watching, and never stop learning.